Stewart has played memorable TV characters for more than two decades, including the bold and blunt Billie on Offspring.
Okay, I definitely didn't bunch up like this in the shop. Is this a fat mirror? Or am I retaining some sort of...
No, if you do 100 sit-ups, you get tight abs for the next 5 hours.
Well,
yep, so... standard date prep. I usually do 200, but I wouldn't advise that you do that many.
Okay, thanks, Billie.
You realise you haven't de-owled the room? Ow, 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 ow.
What's wrong with ours?
Well, they're almost totally sexless, as birds go.
Oh, come on, it's not as if Chris is going to walk in here and say, oh, I see owls, no sex for you.
Well, not consciously, no.
Now Kat is taken to the stage in Admissions, a new satirical play, and she joins us now from Melbourne. Kat, it's a pleasure to speak to you. This play is very different.
Oh, you too.
And this play is very different from what audiences might be used to seeing you in. Can you tell us a little bit about it?
Well, this is A, exciting that it's a play because it's been so long since we've all been in the theatre, but B, it's a comedy, not unlike Offspring, I suppose, but it's a kind of a comedy with teeth. I think if you're going to give it a little line, you'd say it's a black comedy about white privilege. But it's also a comedy about families, and I'm having a great time rehearsing it.
What was it that drew you to the character?
The character I'm playing is called Cherie, and she's, I guess, a bit of a tiger mum. She's really protective of her son, but she's also a really passionate idealist, and those sort of... those key kind of needs kind of collide in this play in a way that's really surprising, a little bit outrageous and really entertaining. So, this sort of made me sit up straight when I first read it, and I thought, oh, this is something I'd want to see, and it was something I was really excited to be able to do.
Yeah, that's great. The play has been described as provocative and a hard lesson. How much has it shifted your worldview?
Well, I think it's not a play that gives you answers, but it's really provocative. I think it's going to be the kind of play that'll entertain people, but also on the drive home, you'll have discussions about it and maybe question yourself a little bit. And white privilege, it's set in America, it's set in New Hampshire in the kind of the university, college kind of world, but it's something that we're not immune to here in Australia. So, yeah, no, it's made me kind of interrogate things here too. I think it's timely and it's entertaining as well as being really informative and provocative.
Oh, we love everything you do. It's so good to see you back in theatre, but we also love your stuff on the telly as well in the third season of Five Bedrooms. It premiered early this year. What was it like filming those past couple of seasons during lockdown? That must have been tough.
It was so weird. The second series we had to stop for 3 months and then we went back to it. And then we did all of series three during lockdown number six in Melbourne. So it was kind of pretty mad behind the scenes because, you know, there were interstate cast we couldn't get. The writers were brilliantly rewriting scenes, but we were just so grateful to be able to work. And I love doing that show so much. So, you know, I was just so grateful to be able to work every day because so many people couldn't, especially in this industry.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah. Kat Stewart is brilliant in anything and everything she does. You can see Kat in Admissions at Southbank Theatre from March 5. And, of course, you can stream seasons 1 to 3 of Five Bedrooms on Paramount+. Chookers, Kat, can't wait to see it.
Thank you. Thanks for having me.
Bye.